Hello and welcome back to the Sonicview XP Learning Center. In this video, we're going to cover two different topics. One of them is stereo linking channels, and the other is aux versus bus and how to set those up. So here on channel 17 and 18, I'll click this and we're taken to our input menu of channel 17. At the bottom, we have the option for stereo link and it currently says off. So let me touch that. And now it gives us two options. So we have 16 and 17 right here that we can use, which are both, you know, those are in two different eight channel banks. Or we can do channel 17, 18, which are both on the same bank. So let me select channel 17 and 18 first. Okay, now those are stereo linked. And as you saw, the fader automatically pulled down here on channel 18. So if I come back to this and I turn it off, fader pops back up. So we're still on channel 17. Let's go back to stereo link and now we'll do channel 16, 17. So now 17 goes down. And now we can see here, we have channel 16 and 17 on one channel, stereo linked. So I'll click this and we'll go to off. And there we go. So they're no longer stereo linked. Now, we'll address the difference between our mixes, whether they're in aux or bus mode. So let me go to our mix level here, mix layer. So here we see all of our mixes. This is everything that we have here. Some of these we can see are orange, and then some of these are purple. Anything that's orange is considered an aux. Anything that's in purple is considered a bus. So let's get into the menu and we'll take a look at that as well. So we'll go to the menu. Now in mixer setup, we'll go to mix config, bus config. Now we'll tap that. So this is going to combine both of the things that we were talking about. So for mix one and two, we see we have, let's go to this. Mix one and two, we see we are in mono, but we can stereo link those and now they become one. And then if you look here at the scribble strip, fader came down for mix two and now they're on the same one. I'm going to undo that. And let's scroll across our screen here. And we see when we get to our buses, well, they're labeled as buses here, but they're still our mixes. They go from aux down to group. There's a big distinction here between these. So let's take a look at mix one. I'm going to go to my first layer, and we're going to take a look at the kick drum here so we can see exactly what's happening. So let's select our kick drum. We'll go to our send screen. And we can see here we have mix one. So we can use our encoder, we can do fine gain adjustments to that, as you can see right here, or we can do coarse gain adjustments and add as much or as little as quickly or slowly as we want between those two options. Now, what happens if we go to our mix one, we'll select that, we go to our outputs, and there we've got our outputs where we can send things to. We can go to analog, you know, Dante, slots, USB outs, all of that great stuff. So now I want to go back to our channel one again. Now, when we over here in the mix config screen, I'm going to switch from aux to group. There we go. So now we can see that that switched to purple. But if you noticed over here on this screen, something very important happened. So our ability to send signal to mix one as a group was now defeated. So aux, there we go. We can send signal, which means it's pre-fader, right? Switch to group, we can no longer send signal. So that means it's post-fader. So anything that you're doing on this channel that's going to that mix has to be post-fader. So that is a big difference. But we'll go back to our layer. Mix one, which we can now see is also in purple because that has been assigned as a group. We select this, we go back to our outputs, we still have all the same selections here. So both mix one as an aux and mix two, I'm sorry, mix one as an aux and mix one as a group can both be assigned to say analog output one or USB output one. But the main difference here is the signal coming into it. Again, to reiterate, as an aux, our sends, we have the freedom to adjust everything we want of the signal coming into it. As a group, strictly post fader, and we can no longer adjust this without adjusting our overall mix. We hope that clears things up for you, and stick around and check out some more of our great Sonicview XP Learning Center videos so you can become a master of the Sonicview 24, make your workflow easier and quicker, and get things done as an engineer. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon.